Hello and welcome. I'm Laura Brandenburg from Bridging the Gap, here today with Kira Judge from what Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, Canada. I practiced that a few times and we joke. Kira's like, don't say it five times fast. But a senior business analyst in that area here to share about her experience with both our Blueprint program and Circle of Success and just some of the amazing successes that she stepped into in her BA career this year. So thank you so much for being here, Kira.
You're welcome, Laura. I'm very grateful that I have this opportunity to participate in your case studies and in a way inspire other business analysts to recognize the important channel to help each other out. Because what I find as a business analyst, we can be perceived as a problems because we discover the problems, we realize the missing requirements, we realize this, we bring lights to things that might be missed, right? So we are the, and depending on your engagement with business, if you're trying to solve the business problem, you can be just on the technology side, but still you're bringing value to business. So that intention to bring value to business, then you can justify your questions, you can justify some resentment and resistance from your colleagues because you're bringing value to business. And it's okay. It's okay to bring value to business because that's why you're there. You're a business analyst. So I'm very grateful that I am contributing to understanding and appreciation of this profession because it's very important. And as you know, business analysts need it everywhere. And as Laura points out, success of the project depends on the confident and competent business analyst.
And that's really one of the big transformations I've seen in your work this year is just the confidence and how you show up with both the skills and the mindset side of what you're doing. And I love how you articulated, like, we're problem finders, right? So that can create that negative perception, but we're finding those problems in order to solve problems or to solve them, right? So can you just take us back to where you were maybe January this year? I know you chose the Blueprint and Circle of Success like back to back, but kind of where were you at earlier in this career and what were you looking to achieve going forward?
So in 2019, January, I think I received an email from you, join Circle of Success. And it was amazing. I was looking at that time, what I want to do, who I am, where I want to be, and that email that I received from you about Circle of Success was just amazing timing. And because I already developed trust, and your program is, your templates and your handouts are very helpful, even before I joined Circle of Success, even before I joined Blueprint, I knew it was very credible source, and it was no question for me, will it be valuable or not? And I like the fact that you were very authentic saying, this is a brand new thing. And I like the fact that you said that you're founding members. And I thought it's such an opportunity to try something new. Mm-hmm. You know, we can be very lonely because professional business analysts are everywhere. Like you can find business analysts in finance, business analysts in IT, business analysts in business. So it is somewhat very wide profession. However, all we're trying to solve is business problems most of the time. So in January, I made myself a New Year present.
And so it sounded like you were kind of already thinking about where do I want to go with my career? And you were in a business analyst role, correct?
Yeah.
And from more of a business background, is that?
I'm an economist. Mm-hmm. I came from kind of business intelligence side. Mm-hmm. And it was kind of a journey for me as well, because I was in business side. And every time we solve business problem, it all kind of comes to can you validate this business proposition or can you validate this business outcome? And it all comes to data, right? And so that's how I moved from business to IT and particularly into data, data hub in a way. So I work in enterprise information management where every information that exists in the enterprise is with us or coming to us. So yeah, I'm very much enabled to deliver solutions for business, but also I have to constantly communicate that I need to understand. Before I put anything valuable, I need to understand. And I was using already 8 steps that you help. You have this, like I'm not in my office, but I have a showing 8 steps, understand. And if you have questions, go back to understand. And it, of course, there is some kind of a balance. You have to strike a balance between analysis paralysis. And if it's going there, you just ask questions like, am I right to go this way? And the communication is very important. And I was using one of your templates again. I think it's called a business requirements. I forgot the name, but it's you kind of saying, this is my understanding of what we are trying to achieve and what is your expectations of me wanting to do for you.
Right. So like the business analysis plan, right? Like what are we doing? What's the scope of the project? And what am I actually contributing as the BA? Yeah.
And,
great to get people on the same page.
And before I started Blueprint, I had this strange fear of sending emails. Mm. I used to read 5 times and you know, sometimes you're writing an email, oh, you have to add one more person. And if you're adding another person, then you think 5 times and you kind of, you know, you're paralyzing yourself.
Yeah.
But with the circle of success, actually, my combination of circle of success in January and then starting Blueprint at the end of February, it was just an amazing combination because circle of success is a team, a group of people who just there to support and help each other out. And Blueprint was just that technical skills that I needed. How I'm going to create clarity when there is no clarity?
Yeah. How
do you dig down in the business process to understand what is needed, who is interacting what? For example, when I learned the use cases, I understand, okay, there is no emotions here. Like there is machine is doing what you want it to do. And from business analysts, you say, okay, when machine says this, what user do? And when user do this, what machine does, right? So it's clear dive in picture of what this activity in the business process, if it's interacted with certain technology, have to do for you. And then the last thing was the EAG. That was incredible. It was super timing for me. At that time, I was doing some kind of it's a project, short project. We needed to find out the capability of our business enterprise, what can we do with the supply chain data? So it was super timely for me because when I started that project, I was studying the ERG with Blueprint. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it came along so well. In fact, Doug helped me, okay, Kira, you need to understand that ERGs made in order to make business better, right? So I remember arguing with Doug, like, no, this is what it is. And he's like, I know what business, your business is doing, but the higher level, you have to understand that this problem have to go at some point. Because what was happening is like, I was trying to solve the current problem, but Doug was saying, you have to look higher. You have to assume that problem will disappear at some point. Otherwise, you're building the problem in the system, right?
Into the system. Oh, that's amazing.
And you're kind of accepting that mistake or the error will be constantly there. So, anyway,
So I'm curious about this because you are an economist, you are working in business intelligence already, which to me means like you've got the data, right? But then the ERD lesson and the learnings still had a big impact for you.
Absolutely.
Can you kind of describe that gap, like kind of what the gap was and what you had before and what was that next level?
I think what was missing in my knowledge is that and Doug helped me out, like, so data has to live somewhere in order to bring the value to business, not only to solve one problem, but many other problems for the entire enterprise. So when you're solving one business problem, you tend to solve that particular business problem only, and then you chase, right? But what an enterprise, what ERG helped me to understand is like you build the system not only for this particular business problem, but for the other potential business questions. Mm. It's quite empowering. Like, okay, I see. And it kind of showed that, and I don't want to say anything negative about the existing system, it kind of showed that sometimes when we not question or when we don't ask deeper questions, we kind of build system that solve the problem maybe, or at least they attempt to solve the problem, but actually they created something that kind of loop back, and then it's kind of stuck, right? So like, again, like somebody else didn't think through, and then we end up with this, with second best, or maybe sometimes it's even worse. And so Doc's questioning was like, yeah, this is so, so important, because when you're building something, you have to think big, long-term, right? Mm-hmm. There's a challenge, okay, oh, then you have to analyze all of them. Yes, I know. So it's kind of a balance, constantly balance. And when you challenge saying, okay, you're analyzing too long, you can say, yes, it's true. Then define me, my business objectives. Help me define me. What you want me to do? How do you see? How would else you would do? For example, if I'm new to the environment and I'm making a business process, I can say, this is not relevant or that's not relevant, right? You need to have certain level of expertise to say, this is not relevant for my steps. But when you're learning new things, you have to know everything. At least that's what I am challenged by, that a lot of projects want to deliver really fast, and now they are moving to agile. So it's a challenge, no problem, but the confidence that you have, that you're bringing value, you have tools that you go back and read, okay, what questions I have to ask? How do I communicate my value? What tools I use to communicate my value to this project or to this activity? So yeah, it's amazing that within 1 year, my confidence level is incredibly increased, and the circle of success every day, recording your wins. You know, it's looked like when you read my wins, like, oh my God, I have no problems. But actually, it's your choice. Are you going to focus on the problems, or are you going to focus on the value that you brought today?
Right. And I love how you celebrate your wins. I want to come back to that too. But before I lose this thought, you shared something a few minutes ago about like the time that you spent working on an email, right? And kind of worrying about who was on that email and how it was phrased, and how that feels like it's like a big shift. And I know that probably feels like a small thing, but I think this is a big deal in our environment, right? Like VAs probably spend a lot of time on emails. And so could you just kind of walk through what's different now when you sit down to write an email? Like, how are you thinking about it now in a different way? Whether or not it has anything to do with the course materials, just like what's switched for you?
I guess the level of being, so if I compare myself a year ago and now, for some reason there was this internal beliefs that you don't bring value. Mm. there to, like, if you're adding one additional person and then if your information is not valuable, then see, like, there's this paralyzing belief, right, that you're not bringing value.
Right.
That your email will take away somebody's time, that your information will cause somebody to get frustrated. So this is kind of an additional fear and belief, or at least an additional fear that you're going to cause something that is not real.
Right.
So this, the change is, I am not going to be paralyzed by this thought.
Yeah. And that you believe in your value so that you know that email is going to have a positive impact.
Yeah. So if somebody is not really happy, they will tell me. But most of the time, so it's all good.
Yeah.
So, yeah. So, and sometimes it happens that if somebody is truly unhappy, I pick up the phone or make a lunch, you invite and say, hey, let's find out what I have to do in the future, because past is past. I'm not going to dwell on the past. What should we do from now and on?
Yeah.
And if I've done something that offended you, I'm fully accepting that I'm human, you're human. All I needed is to achieve A or Z, right?
Mm-hmm. And that comes from within, right?
Yes.
So there's nothing external that changed. It's like, yeah, that value has to start here.
Yeah,
and then when the external stuff comes up, you have that resilience to handle it.
Yeah.
I love that. I love that so much. And I know it probably seems like a small thing to you with the emails, but like sometimes it's those small things that really show us like the bigger shifts. So thank you for diving into that. And so let's come back to the wins, because you've said a few times, like, Laura, I'm your win hunter. Right. And you do. You are so great and have this amazing habit to post your wins almost every single day. I won't call you out. Once in a while, I'm like, where's Kira's wins today? But almost every single day in our Slack group for the Circle of Success. And it's setting the tone for everyone else too, which I just want to express my appreciation, because other people jump in because they see your example. But talk about how that's affected you.
Again, it's focus, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I was so amazed that not only me, but Tracy is also following the same pattern. Like, first thing in the morning, instead of listening to negative news, I read Good News Network. And there's so many inspiring news. Somebody help out somebody. Somebody's help turn an amazing experience for somebody who needs it. So there's so many good things happening in the world. But unfortunately, if you focus on negativity, then you will find negativity. So that's my tool. I am going to record my wins today. Yes, I had a crappy message from project manager, but I'm going to celebrate my wins. I am going to learn. Like, so this experience, for example, it made me to realize something I missed. I'm taking accountability. I missed something. I have no blame. Yeah, I'm human. I'm busy. I have, like, you should see my email. Like, there's 30 emails every morning. So possibly I missed something. So I go back to Blueprint, or maybe as a result of Blueprint, I have the access to the masterclass. So there is a clear message from you. How to communicate business objectives, how to find out business objectives. But it's true that a lot of the time, every group, technology can have this and business can have this. Your final client wants this. And if it's not clarified and written down and communicated, everybody will be doing what they assume.
Mm-hmm.
So those tools makes me very confident that whatever I'm doing, I'm bringing value. And the wins is there for me to record what I've done today, to validate myself, to inspire myself. Because if you don't inspire yourself, who will? Right? There's a lot of negativity, unfortunately. And so you have to literally be that person who supports yourself. Because I think a lot of us kind of have negative thoughts because, you know, things happen and you're living in a world where there's a lot of things happening, good and bad. But for some reason, if you don't focus on positivity, if you don't focus on supporting yourself, nobody will. You have to support yourself. You have to pull. And that's why my win are very important. So sometimes I have lots of them, and sometimes not many, but I still have this habit of inspiring others, right?
Yeah.
And the other thing, when you inspire others, you will find sources of inspiration in others as well. And the circle of success lessons are amazing. So recently we did the negotiation, salary negotiation. Mm-hmm. So even you didn't say, like, you tried all the tools and then you didn't get, but still there was amazing tool, like you still come out decent saying, okay, if there is no room, then I'm fine too. But the most important thing, you're trying to get higher wages, right? And what's wrong with that? So
right.
It is very, very practical. And I like the fact that it's not Facebook. And I'm sorry, I just don't like Facebook because there's so many not so positive results from Facebook. So that's why I like Slack, because it's people that I know, I trust, and you can share. And I like our motto that we inspire each other, and sometimes you so need it, like you need that group.
Well, we inspire each other and celebrate each other, but we're also there when somebody has a challenge, right? So that, you know, so there is that, there is both, right? Sometimes we do need the support of the community to get through whatever is in front of us, but we show up. I think I like what you said with the accountability, the personal responsibility, the finding the results or looking for the solution in that problem. And sometimes we do need some help to get to that point. And so it's there for both reasons. Yeah. Anything stand out to you from a teaching perspective in the circle of success that has had a big influence?
I think the abundance teaching, abundance and value. Mm-hmm. Remember when it was perfect timing for me too. Remember when money changes hands, you're creating value.
Yeah.
So, you know, like everybody has different background, and my for some reason I had this belief that when you spend money, you're making yourself worse. So, and help that the lesson we learn about changing the hands, the value when you change hands, made me like, wow, this is incredible. So yeah, there's so many little things that I am applying, and it's just incredible how it is kind of coming together. And in even my personal relationship, my husband is really impressed by my change.
He's like, that's awesome.
So he's like, where's my wife? New me and old me.
Yeah.
And to be fully transparent, I think if I wasn't ready for Circle of Success, I wouldn't pick up, right? So negativity in me would say, nah, it's just whatever. But my readiness to help myself was there.
Right? Yeah.
So before that, I changed jobs and I needed support from BA Group. And although I'm not new to the company, that Realm is relatively new to me, but that was such a super timing for me that I made myself a present. And another video that I have to mention is that with the blueprint you sent, if your manager is not understanding the value you're going to bring, send this email. And that in the email you had a message to my managers. So I waited that, I think I paid myself in February and actually waited until end of June. And I had this confidence because that I had confidence that I am learning such a valuable things for my enterprise. And it was. And at the end of the day, they said, yeah, it's looked like so amazing because, you know, everybody's so busy. Like it gets so busy. People get, I said to my manager, have a great weekend. You know, he showed me his email. This is my weekend activity. 550 emails. He has to go through 550 emails. Oh. And realize, oh my God, they literally, people are so busy. And how on earth you're going to convince that your piece is more important, right? So you literally have to bring value by being authentic, by understanding, and compassion is very important too, like to understand, okay, if person have to go through 550 emails, right? Yeah. So we can't waste 550 emails. And the higher you go, that number will go only up.
Okay. I have to work on that belief for you, but we'll work on that one. But
yeah, see, you got my limitation.
And yeah, there's always something, right, that keeps you from the next level. That's part of what we do. I love that you submitted it and they had seen the value in you already, like in the program and in the changes that you've made from between February and June, that it was like an easy thing for them to reimburse you for the course. Is that?
Yeah. So it worked out so well.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's part of what you do is you actually do the work while you're going through the course. So you get the value right away too. That's awesome.
And I like the fact that you always have videos like if your managers are not valuing, because it seems to me you're from real world who experience those challenges.
Yeah.
So that's very valuable for me.
Awesome. And Kira, you know, the other, you've been very generous with your time and thank you. One of the things I just want to call out too is like you have this very rich and vibrant personal life, right? So like we've been talking about your career, but like I am just so impressed with like you have your morning routine and you bike to work and you have all these pieces that you incorporate into this very, very full and busy work day. So do you have any tips for people on, I don't even want to call it balance, that's kind of the wrong word these days, but any tips on maintaining that kind of a lifestyle with a busy, full career, obviously high pressure job like you have?
I think it's recognizing and accepting what it is. Right? Then the positivity, very important piece. My son told me this, it was incredible. He was like maybe 11 years old. And he said, Mom, do you know how many muscles you spend when you frown? And I have no idea. Muscle power or something? I have no idea. 45. And how many muscles you spend when you smile? I have no idea. 50. And then he taught me, when you smile, you're just not wasting so much energy. And when you frown, you're wasting a lot of energy. So then somehow I connected. Oh my God, that's the tool I have to use. When we are positive, we are not wasting too much energy. And that's where you have additional energy to swim in the morning, to, you know, spread inspiration to others and take care of yourself, right?
Yeah.
Because that's meditation in the morning, swimming in the morning, biking, it's all part of taking care of myself, my connection with nature, right? So the River Healer story.
Mm-hmm.
It gets so crazy. Everybody wants something. So you go out, take care of yourself. Because if I don't take care of myself, I will screw up.
Yeah. So, I love that. That's a great example.
It's all about energy level. Like you have to have good energy. And in order to have that good energy, you have to take care of yourself and inspire yourself.
Yeah. All right. So last question. What does success look like for you?
What does success look like? My relationship with everybody I care have to be in good level, understanding and compassion and trust from my colleagues, from my leaders and my business partners. So trust and relationship, I think. And then they too go together, right? You cannot have relationship if you don't trust each other.
Yeah, that's beautiful. Beautiful. And one of the things I just keep noticing in our circle and in our community is like success looks a little bit different to everyone. So I always like to understand what it really looks like to the people that inspire me every day. So thank you so much, Kira. I really appreciate your time. I'm super excited to share this with everyone. I think everyone will have some great insights to take away. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you, Laura.
You're welcome.